Why, hello there!
Welcome to the 80s! Inflation skyrocketed after an aftermath of events due in the late 70s, like the oil crisis. Due to increasing oil prices, the Fed sharply cut interest rates. They wanted to encourage growth, but they didn't do it in the right way.
Food and gas prices have inflated so much that inflation is too high. It looks like the federal government only has one choice, and implement an action of restrictive monetary policy.
Let's take diamonds and water, for example. Is it hard for you to get water?
No.
Right, but is it hard to get diamonds?
Yes.
And why is that?
Well, because they're rare.
Exactly, because there's less of them, and they're more valuable. It's the same way with money. When there's too much money in the system, inflation goes up.
In restrictive monetary policy, the Feds increase interest rates, but they cannot change prices directly. By increasing interest rates, it means that money becomes more rare. This causes the supply curve to shift to the left on the demand. Supply of loanable funds goes down and money is harder to borrow. The shift in the supply and demand of goods and services are a result of the new interest rates. However, because of the decrease of money supply in the economy, the effect causes the demand for goods and services to go down, a shift to the left of the demand curve.
What's going on? Why am I asleep on a for sale sign?
Well, everybody's selling their houses. They can't afford them anymore.
Why'd they buy them in the first place?
See, that's the problem. Underqualified borrowers were encouraged to buy houses they couldn't afford. The Fed made it so those who couldn't afford houses could buy them anyway. See, the plan was pay a small interest rate now and a higher interest rate later, and then sell before the rate rises.
Everyone started doing it, but nobody had the money. So when it came time to flip their house, these underqualified owners were hoping to borrow against a higher house value in the future. They planned to flip their house so there'd be more than enough money to repay their mortgage. But when everyone was trying to do this with money they didn't have, it caused loans to default.
This housing crisis causes an immediate reduction in cash flow. Nobody can flip their houses in time, and with no money in the system, no money is being spent, halting economic flow and causing a recession.
So the Fed is going to attempt a expansionary policy?
Exactly.
Okay.
Because as Keynes says, a time like this calls for an increase in aggregate demand. They need to stimulate the flow of money again. Let me show you what it would look like in a perfect world.
In an expansionary monetary policy, the government is trying to increase the money supply. To do that, the federal government is going to decrease interest rates, because that means cheaper money. On a graph, it means the supply curve shifts to the right. There's now more money available. There's a larger supply for loanable funds because it's easier to gain a loan and much easier to pay it back. As a result of this, demands for goods and services also shift to the right, meaning there is more of a demand for those things because there's more money in the people's pockets. They started something called quantitative easing, a plan set up in phases to slowly pump money into the economy by buying bonds. As they buy them, they're putting money in and taking bonds out. This creates real output and employment in the short run, but they've got to be careful. If they expand too far, it causes a recession, and then we're back to the 80s.
What are we doing here?
Well, I'm just a teacher, so you're going to tell me what the most effective monetary policy is for the future? Nope.
Won't you come see about me?
My name is Dana Calder, and I approve this message.